Hi guys, in last section we have created a Maven project. Now in this we'll create a class and run through testng and pom.xml. Okay, so first you create a package. So I created com.learning. So on the test, just go and just create a new package and give your name com.learning I given, and under that I'll create a class called Jenkins demo. Okay, create a class and give a name to it. Okay, I given Jenkins demo here. Okay, now we'll go to this class. Okay, so I written a simple Selenium code which will launch the browser and just compare the title. So you just copy paste this thing and later we discuss Selenium. So in Maven last session we had downloaded our all Selenium and testng dependency. So I created class Jenkins.demo. This at the rest test is testng annotation. Okay, after that I want a Chrome driver, so I set the property. And like Firefox we come with Selenium, but when you want to use Chrome you have to download this chrome.driver.exe file and you have to run this set property. So this is path I have saved, this chrome.driver. You want to save anywhere you can save and just give this path. Then I'm creating a web driver and I'm opening the Google application. So I just put this URL and then here I'm driver.get will launch the browser and I execute it. Then I'm comparing the title, like what actual title about this, and just finishing the test. So this is a simple code. So before you execute, one more thing, just point to, like when you create a new project it will be Java 1.5 or something, just point to JDK 1.8. how you'll do, just right click build, configure build path, and what Java is there, just go edit and just go workspace JRE or anywhere, like you install somewhere, install JRE and you want to add and point to that location, next, and directory where your JDK is there 1.8, just select and done, just select this home folder. Okay, so that way you can do. So just point your project with JDK 1.8. Okay, after that you have to create testng.xml file. Testng, we'll discuss all this thing, but right now what you'll do, just see this. This testng will be like to how you want to execute test case. Now everything will be decided by, so later I'll take this session. So just right now you write this thing. So this anywhere you just search for sample testng file on Google, you can get a testng file. So here what we have to give under this test classes, you have to give our path of our class com.learning.jenkins.com. okay, this thing you have to do. After that go to pom.xml file. So in last section what we have done, we have downloaded this dependency. Okay, and this thing will come when we create a project. So now what we are doing here, we are giving in this properties block, I just declare suit file name and gave the path of testng.xml file. Okay, after that under this build clause you have to specify this thing, like here it will pick up our testng xml file where the all test cases are detailed. So this pom.xml get to know that where our test case details are there. So you have to just copy paste this thing, and this is for like which compiler you want and which version you want. So I have just recorded, 1 second. So this is build.xml file, you have to write down, and everything should be under project. Okay, so just going. Okay, after that what you do, go to run configuration. Okay, you just configure once under Maven build. Now just when you come here, you just click this new, you click new, one thing will have open here. Okay, then you select work, just give a name. Okay, any name you want, test one I am giving right now, and just select the workspace. So we have to select all your workspace is there, and then you have to, this is our goal, clean install. So what it'll do, it will clean the directory, m2 directory, and again download everything and run the test case. Just apply and run. So you now you see our test case, the Maven test is started. Okay, now it's running test case. It's just picking up test from testng.xml file. Now it's opening the browser, is validating that this title is matched with that and passing the test. So that way we'll do our test. So in next section, right now we have run tests in Eclipse only. Next time we integrate with Jenkins and we trigger from Jenkins. Thank you.